Welcome back, everybody, to Radiation World. Yesterday, we killed a bunch of mechanoids by staring them in the face and gunning them down. At the same time, our nuclear reactor went haywire, and now we've got to deal with radiation. I don't know what exactly the effect of this is going to be. I assume it's very similar to a toxic fog. Let's just quickly blast through everyone, see if anyone's got... So you've been shot the leg, you need tending. Of course, we are still working on tending our people as well. How's Rose doing? Rose. Oh, Rose, I am going to argue with you. You've got people bleeding out, and she's sleeping. Brilliant. Let's go ahead and get it down there to tend to these people. What, prioritize? Tend to Pierre. Yeah, I'm sure you are. I would like you to tend to... Am I losing my mind here? Try to arrest. Rest still here. Nope, she won't... Why can you not tend to Upsa? Oh, let's Watsit's already on it. No, Watsit is asleep. I have no idea, but I'm going to wake everybody. I'm just going to draft and undraft everybody to have them fully reset, because it's a complete mess. Anyway, I'll go through manually in a second to put the ones in the hospital that need it as priority here. Apparently, the way that we deal with, according to the comment section yesterday, the way we deal with these reactor meltdowns are to, the second we get a solar flare, have somebody over there to cut the power. So that's what we'll have to try and do. I guess we, how do you even turn it off in hindsight? Set target fuel level to zero? Toggle? I don't know how we turn it off in hindsight. Either way, I'm sure I'll figure it out, but basically we need to cut it off of power somehow. The next time we immediately get a solar flare. So at least I know roughly what we need to do next time to try and avoid this mess. But again, I'm going to guess it's probably just similar to a toxic fallout. So let's sit indoors and get ourselves healed up. So I'm just going to quickly go through everybody now and make sure that the people who need it the most are the ones healed up. It's because this episode doesn't need tending, you moron. Good God. Right, okay, let's try that again. Right, okay, I think I've made it now so that the people with life-threatening or persistent injuries are the ones with the hospital beds. Rose should be coming down. I'm also going to get Watsit down here as well to help tend to people as well. Because by the time he gets down here, I assume Pierre, who's the one who's pretty significantly injured here, he should be down there ready to be tended to as well. Look at the bio waste we've got with all these people. Good God, that's really ramped it up, hasn't it? 1,004. We might need some more of these biosolids. Composter in hindsight. I might turn this into a room. Bear in mind it needs a particular temperature. We could use this overwall cooler to create a basically a warm room for mulching down shit. I mean, it's gonna have a horrendous smell, but it works out pretty decently, I think, given that this will keep it at a nice temperature. So, I mean, honestly, why not? Let's do exactly that, and that way we can have it immediately adjacent to the farms as well. If we get a door on it, people aren't going to be in there too frequently. Let's go ahead and get these reinstalled as well. That way we can use this room for some other stuff if we feel like it. Rather than having... I just feel like it's not very cash money to have a bunch of biosolid composters no less than, you know, 2-3 meters away from where we handle all of our meat. It just doesn't seem very good for not dying of horrible food poisoning. Anyway, or dysentery. Let's go ahead and get all this stuff moved over. Okay. Okay. Well-known comment section. Good work on dealing with the mystery of why the animals wouldn't eat the food. So they are defaulting to lavish. And of course, many, 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 many episodes ago when we barely had any food, I specifically in lavish made it so they couldn't eat... Oh my God, yeah, that was absolutely it. I made it so they couldn't eat raw corpses, so that our people obviously wouldn't eat raw corpses. I didn't realize that animals defaulted to lavish food. How am I supposed to make... How am I supposed to give the animals animal food by default? Oh, shit. Okay. It looks as if it's probably easier to... probably looks like it's easier to instead edit the food restrictions, copy lavish if possible... rename lavish to just animals and allow all. Let's say animals. And, fucking my God. Just what an absolute mess of spelling there. Animals, allow all. And then change our people over to bottom animals, which I'm going to rename to lavish. And then this one, restrict the meals instead. Is there really no way to manually adjust animals like that in hindsight? Good God. Okay, there is obviously one of them eating there that I need to switch back to. There we go, back to animals. Good Lord, I can't believe that they default to lavish meals and there's no way to just mass bulk adjust them. Otherwise, I guess they'd have to sit here going through all of them. Yeah, that's crazy. Okay, well, let's go ahead and do what I had before with this then. Oh, wait, no, the new one was animals that we want to give to our people, right? Oh, no, I renamed it. We're good. Right, so no corpses at all, basically. Preferably no raw meat either, and definitely no... To be honest, would I rather them starve than have disgusting nutrient-paste meals? I mean, no, I guess not, even though it is quite a heavy mood debuff. The only thing I don't want is raw meat. That can go off the list. Oh, my spiders can finally eat. We don't need the psychopath orc. Okay, granted you would get more meat out of it, obviously butchering them up, but it would be a bit more effective, but that's a pretty effective disposal method there. Nice work. Okay, good shit. Well, obviously we do need to kill some of these blizzard risks off, because there are an absurd amount there. Absolutely fantastic. Okay, then. How are my ground runners doing? Because we should probably send some more food down to those guys, too. Probably quite hungry. Oh, they got 1,000 down here. Still haven't found anything, though, have they? We don't have to worry about steel so desperately. Bear in mind that we've got all these mechanoids now that are actually in the process of being hauled over and obviously disassembled, too, which is quite nice. That is the highest priority there. And then, as I recall, we weren't far off of getting our next... Yeah, 2.1 days before we get our mega tithe that we've got... Kind of nicely queued up. Oh my god, I didn't get his batteries to the grid. We got the Tetra Slug specifically charging them up, and then I forgot to actually hook them up there. Right, let's go ahead and... Oh no, otherwise they'll have to remove that, won't they? Let's do that one. So to make up for the fact that we are sending the Ground Runners all the hay grass, I've given the Tetra Slug a very weird route where he basically either spends all day by the batteries or goes down to where the food for the Ground Runners will be stored temporarily, so he can go out and get some of that and then wander back. I should put the Animal Salute Spot over here, though, so at least we will get... We'll get about 8 hours a day charging time off of this guy minimum. If we put it there, it should connect to most of the batteries. Good shit. How's the reactor doing now, then? That's minus 14. As many of you pointed out as well, the frozen columns only go to minus 15. I think I actually read that out loud, so that's completely my bad for missing that one. I think, though, as I recall, yeah, we're at minus 14, so actually having four columns in there is the perfect amount. But building any others would be a waste of time, so keep that how it is. The only issue is, though, if we want to make it insect-proof, which obviously I do, we are going to have to add another cooler as well. So what we'll do then is, yeah, let's do this. We'll have to put down another cooler there and obviously set that to something like minus 18. That way the power usage on it will be very low because it's only going to knock it down by a couple of degrees there. It should be enough to keep this cool, though. The only issue is, if we want to do the same thing here, we'll have to use a wide cooler into the battery room and maybe remove this door. I think I might do exactly that, because it's all just one big hallway, isn't it? Yeah, let's do that. That should be a pretty decent way to mitigate the heat building up in here. Put a double load of water cooler there. Maybe just one of them would do it, and then we'll also set that one. For the time being, though, I will forbid those. Obviously, we've got much bigger use of steel, as in everything, given that we've had that problem for the past four episodes. We've got everything to spend steel on right now. I think a couple of coolers just to try and increase the chance of not getting infestations to the bare minimum. Probably not the best use of things there. What are we building here? Oh, it's our droid replicator. We've got enough steel for that now. Oh, fantastic. Okay, so I was given a heads up that regards to the steel droid fabricator that apparently when we build them, they will come out with the purple textures until we reload the game. So when I craft them, we will reload that very quickly to avoid that happening in the future. Manufacture worker droid. Is that what we're making there? DO9A needs 225 steel and 8 components. It's very expensive, but with the tithe, we should be able to bring that together. That's quite a cool little graphic there as well. Clothing's on the way to go and calm down some of the octopus. I'm hoping we can stop them panicking so that we can actually get them down and tend them, because they are bleeding out 15 hours. What have they been shot? Shot in the leg by a charge blaster there. Come on, please. Please break from this. So the other thing as well that I need to test out very soon, and another thing that some people in the comment section have asked me to test out, was calling in our settlements as allies in a conflict. So the next time the Blue Moon Corporation turn up, because those are the guys that... I mean, last time we absolutely wiped them out. It's a shame we didn't get to fight them last time, though, because that would have been... Oh, the time before last, I should say, before I had to reload because the save game broke. Those guys were so easy to deal with, and we got so much good stuff out of them. All the marine armor, all the weaponry. But next time they turn up, mainly because we've gained a lot more colony wealth, they're probably going to be quite difficult. At which point, I'll see if we can call in some of our friendly settlements. I guess that we should probably up the military level as well. 13,000 silver. I think it'd be a shame not to upgrade some of these settlements right now, wouldn't it? Let's do it. Let's go ahead and upgrade the base level rather than founding any more settlements. How much is it? 2,000 silver apiece. We can get all of these upgraded. Holy shit, yeah, do it. Leaves us with 5,400 steel. Can we upgrade our... So our main one is 3,000. Yeah, do it. Okay, that seems like a really good idea. So we not only get the workers, but obviously going to help out with our profits a bit more, going to help out with our tithe. More importantly, military level might come in handy for those future Blue Moon raids. What are you making right there? Unfinished limestone grand sculpture. That's going to take a long ass time. My God. Besides that, though, we have been sort of passively working on some other sort of quality of life things. There's nothing particularly, I think, worth pursuing right now in terms of research until we've dealt with the steel issue, which in theory we've dealt with. But things like, if we go to the hygiene tab, we've got things like hot tubs, power showers, we've got their smart toilets as well, and automatic cleansing and deodorization. Oh, twice as water efficient as well. That's quite cool. But these are quite high luxury things, aren't they? Although getting a hot tub down in the recreation room would be kind of cool. I mean, that worked out pretty goddamn perfectly for the biosolids. Oh, the hauling bot can fill up the biosolids composters. That's quite cool. So it's staying a fairly consistent. The highest I sort of got up to was 53, but then temperature dropped back down to 48 and then it jumped back up to 53. Bear in mind that the optimal temperature for composting is anywhere between 19 degrees C to 60 degrees C. We're keeping it at the very highest end there, so if we get a power cut, it should keep the temperature high enough. I'm going to keep a close eye on it, make sure it doesn't get too close to 60, otherwise we'll have to cool this room as well, which obviously seems to be a bit pointless. Just make sure it doesn't get much higher than that, though, because I assume if it goes too high, it can have the opposite effect of slowing it down. Oh, man, it does get quite hot in there. 53, 52, 55. Oh, shit. Where is all this temperature coming from? We've accidentally built ourselves the world's greatest heater. No, look, it seems pretty good. Yeah, it seems to hover around 54 maximum. That works quite well. The looks of it, the radioactive fog then seems to be a less dangerous toxic fall. That might be the best way to phrase it. Because look through all the animals, none of those guys have, from what I can see, none of them have any sort of toxic fallout. And I haven't restricted them to indoors or anything like that. Same with our own people. They've just been wandering around doing their own thing, working where is appropriate. Nobody has any toxic fallout, so I think this is not as bad as I thought it was. It made it sound like a much bigger deal. Obviously, the immediate death within 11 meters or whatever it was yesterday was a little bit of a concern, but we had the child sacrifice there to go and deal with it. So that is the downside to these reactors then, I guess, is that they can go a bit nuclear, but I mean, according to you guys, we can deal with it, so not too concerned. The after effects don't seem anything that's going to really bother us here. I mean, case in point, really, look at the wild animals. They're not bothered by it. Actually, I don't know. Wild animals bothered by toxic fallout? I can understand why they would be, but I can also understand that why they wouldn't be, because that would kind of affect game balance a bit strangely. Yeah, none of these guys are bothered by it at all. Maybe it doesn't even cause toxic fallout in hindsight. Maybe it's just meant to... radioactive fog. What does it say it does? The fog will hinder range attacks until it dissipates. Maybe then it doesn't give any sort of toxic effects and it just makes it so that range combat is slightly harder. Ah, there we go. That looks a little bit better. Starting to dissipate as well. So one thing I've done very quickly as well is I figured why not get a bit of food variety, because I'm looking at the storage and I'm seeing almost 7,000 corn. So what I've done, bear in mind we've got Rim Cuisine 2, and that's something I should really start researching soon. We're about to hit the end of our research list there with the autocannon turrets. I've set up corn, I've set up cucumber vines, I've set up wheat, and I've set up rice there too for a bit of food variety for a change. I figured that'd be kind of nice. Is there any way we can put, like, soil on stone? Just so... Irrigation, hello. We've already got it. That's a shame. Let's go for some of the Rim Cuisine stuff then. Because we've got all these luxuries, but we're just eating very, very basic, boring corn meals. We might as well try and... might as well try and up that a little bit. So, intermediate agriculture, advanced agriculture definitely couldn't go amiss. Let's give our people a bit more variation. You might remember right at the start of the series, too, when we were struggling for food very, very early on building this sort of zone. One of the things I noticed was that our people were gaining opinion for eating rare ingredients, which we've never really encountered it again because they've just been eating garbage corn and things like that. So let's see if we can embrace that a little bit. And I specifically picked only crops that are highly affected by the fertility. All of them have the same 100% fertility sensitivity. Not much point putting something over here if the sensitivity is low, right? Because otherwise we're just wasting all of the biosolids, wasting all of the sprinkler water on crops that don't benefit from it. Now this area too, I'm building back up to avoid any infestations, as minor as they may be. I've also completely redone their jobs as well, because those were a complete mess, to be frank. I mean, they still are very messy to look at a glance. But I've pushed harvest and grow up to just priority one for absolutely everybody. I might make an exception for our researchers again. But we had all of this crazy shit that we've spent a while setting up with the sun columns and the irrigation and the deep wells and the yada yada yada. And everybody was busy off doing other things, none of which were relevant to the farms. And it seems silly not having this stuff... I mean, not having this stuff optimized at all times. So I've also made it so they automatically haul the biosolids over into the farms as well for doing whatever it is they're going to do with that. It seems to take them quite a long time to actually spread the stuff out, though. But yeah, this is hopefully going to be a lot better. What was that noise? You hear that? Who knows what the hell they were doing there? Maybe it was just a sand squid or something. Nice, there we go. Intermediate agriculture means we might want to start basically doing what we've done over here, but with an area like this, for example. Probably couldn't hurt, particularly if we're going to use the soil as well. It doesn't really matter that this stuff isn't rich soil or anything like that. Cool, okay. So what does that actually unlock for us? Knowledge of planting more advanced crops. Like what exactly? We've got access to pumpkins, tomatoes, okay. Mushrooms. I don't think we had barley before. We got eggplants too. Yam. Oh, wow. And then we got all of this stuff down here too. I mean, sugar canes. I haven't even checked down here before. We got coffee too, which we could use to brew up some drinks. Basically, our chefs are going to be very busy. They've got a lot on their hands now. Damn, look at that. 569% fertility, especially now we've got these biosolids set up properly. Is there anything? Oh, it's 570% there. I guess 570% is probably the highest, and then obviously over time with the sprinklers, it dissipates. So that's the highest we're going to expect. That's insane. Animal starvation. Boomalopes. How are you starving? Look at all this. Oh, I suppose there probably isn't any fully grown crops for them to eat. Oh, we seriously got way too many herbivores for this relatively small area. Holy shit. It does say consuming moss. There you go. You got a nice mouthful of moss. It's like me not being able to get groceries. Okay. Speaking of starving to death, how are my grandrunners doing? They've done absolutely nothing once again. I don't know if I'm just getting unlucky here or what the deal with this is, but we've achieved nothing with these mines so far. We got the tiniest little bit of plastic. Well, sure, to be fair, the tiniest little bit of plastic did allow us to set this up. How are we looking with these? I need to actually change the temperature here, genius. Let's go. So I actually floated this idea in Discord, but the only way I can think of that would be a pretty decent method of ensuring that the nuclear reactors don't go into meltdown so urgently would be to fill this with a shitload of coolers and then hypercool it. So that if there is a solar flare, it would take a while for the temperature to go back up to the point of meltdown. But obviously the power usage at that point might be so expensive, it probably wouldn't be worth doing unless we could find some more effective version of cooling. Ah, advanced agriculture. Right, let's see what we can potentially grow here. I'd be more than happy to swap the rice out, to be honest with you. Chili peppers, quinoa, pineapples, grapevines. Oh, this is quite cool. What counts as a rare ingredient is probably my next question. Because I'd love to grow some more of those things that count as rare ingredients so that our people have bonus mood eating their meals. I guess we'll put down the grapevines then. They're a finicky plant that can only be grown in temperate regions, but not in the more humid swamps. I mean, I don't think it really makes that much of a difference, does it? Rimworld doesn't really count much for things like that. This is all just a very temperate zone in general because we're keeping a consistent temperature. I think we need a greenhouse expansion, don't we? I think we are going to have to slightly increase the area of our farms then. So what I'll do is I'll go around this with a wall, but I'll leave a one block gap for things like the piping, for things like the sprinklers, obviously. But we'll go ahead and we'll turn this area into another full-blown indoor greenhouse. Man, I wasn't expecting to run out of room that quickly. Oh, look at this. Here we go. So we got... Oh, damn it. I didn't save enough silver. I broke my cardinal rule there of not saving enough silver to be able to actually pay these bills as they come in. So I'll have to wait for the main largest quarry there to... I will admit, I did slaughter these sand squids because I realized they did only have the effect, unfortunately, on sand, strangely enough. And again, we haven't got enough food for our boomlabs, so they can disappear. Oh, metal alloy barricades. That's cool. I don't know why they've researched that. Oh, it's a set of pulse charge defenses because I figured we should probably work on our defenses as well. First thing I want to do when the taxes turn up is we're going to implement Operation Efficiency. Operation Efficiency is very straightforward. We're going to give everybody tools, either hammers or obviously if they're not builders, they'll get axes. Just to help increase, bear in mind that we're increasing the size of our farms fairly significantly here. Just to increase the amount of, obviously the amount of time that they're spent doing other stuff besides growing, because there is going to be quite a lot otherwise. I might also turn this into another hydroponics base and remove the wind turbines, but we'll talk about that one later. It might be better to do it with something up here or round on the other side of this one. Anyway, we'll set up more hydroponics farms as we go. The other thing I want to do is set up a lot of mechanized armor racks too, so that we can not have everybody constantly wear marine armor or helmets or anything, have them with the civilian gear, and then also have them have the combat gear as well, because if it's over by the killbox, it shouldn't take them too long to actually swap out into that. Yes, there we go. Okay, resolve the bill. Fearers found a lump of buried emerald using the ground penetrating scanner. That's really not what I wanted, but at least this one's a bit more convenient. So how do we do this? Then we go production, we go deep drill, and then we can see the tiniest little fucking bit of emerald. We did find that steel over there. To be honest, that steel would be way more convenient than that. I can't believe it generates new resources in areas that you're unable to get to. It just seems so inconvenient. I know many of you were upset about the lack of goat in your lives. Turns out I was wrong. I thought we butchered him with the manager mod. And it turns out he was here all along in our hearts. Goat. And you can see quite clearly that he is the same goat, despite the fact that he may have different injuries. It doesn't matter. And despite the fact that he's only 1 year old, it doesn't matter. besides that, he is identical. He's the same goat. He was just on a journey from which he has returned, a great pilgrimage to the goat gods, where he has told us a great many things. For example, please finish the golden toilet, Mr. Streamer. You know he's the real goat because there was a lightning bolt. And what would it happen to strike? Of course it would hit goat. A fire burnt goat, scorching his body. That's so fucking funny to me. That the second this goat returns from his pilgrimage, and definitely wasn't just another goat that I renamed, he immediately gets hit by lightning. It's like, genuinely, I couldn't think of a more apt thing than goat being a lightning rod for just pure damage. Another one of the animals also got hit. Tetragenic originate got hit on his protoplasm. So fucking good. It actually could not have gone down any more perfectly. Well, that's not really what I wanted there. 361 gold. Again, great. We can work on the golden bathroom in reverence of forgetting about, almost forgetting about, our good friend Goat One. Let's see, how much can we put down here? Not quite enough for the whole room, but you know, we can do a pretty goddamn decent job there. Hopefully that was including the tiles I'd already put down. Eventually, can we build gold walls? Is that something you can do? Golden walls. Golden walls. Holy shit, we actually can. Let's go trip with that butcher as well, because I'm sure we've got plenty of food. Hopefully they want to buy some corn, because we have more than enough corn right now. Delta, please, for the love of God, trade corn for meat. What have you got for me then? You've got some ewes. Do you want to sell? I'm going to sell these ragu. The game is so laggy right now. I'm just looking for excuses to get rid of some of these animals, I'll be honest with you. Dromedaries, we don't really need the milk. The chameleon yaks as well. I mean, they're cool and all, but the game is so slow that I don't know that I can, justify having them around anymore. Raw meat, that's what we're after. Give me that shit. Goblin meat, iron husk beetle meat, ocular jelly meat. I assume it all counts as meat, but this is what we're after. Look at this. Minus 4,000 corn. Excellent work. What else we got here? They got any? Okay, I was gonna see if they got any fertilized eggs, but apparently not. I don't really want your yak wool. Okay, get rid of all this crap too. Get rid of this shit. There we go. You got some. To be fair, they got some fishes, which count as meat. They got a fair amount of fishes as well. Let's go ahead and buy those up. We'll buy your tuna. Why do goldfish cost almost three times as much as tuna? What the fuck? Okay. This is our lobster and swordfish there as well. I mean, meat is meat at the end of the day, isn't it? Why tuna so cheap? Buy that tuna. Go ahead and swap all that for a bit more corn. What do you think? Sell off like 5,500, leave us with 1,500 corn left over. Although that's a lot of meat at that point that I don't think we really need. I'd rather buy tuna than guppy though. There we go. Absolutely absurd. Absolutely absurd, but that was the real thing that we're lacking right now, because we haven't had any manhunt packs, so I haven't sent anyone out hunting for a while. Basically, we're only relying on the fish that we're getting, and now that I've redone the jobs, they're not going to be spending as much time fishing, although apparently they are. Fish do deteriorate in shallow water, can confirm. Why weren't given the option of lavish meals? Do they not consume that over? Why did he eat that rather than the? That's so strange. Okay, it's nothing to do with their food restriction there. Just randomly decided. Maybe it's because it was someone else. Again, what's it doing it to there? Maybe it's to do with the fact that someone else was getting the food or interacting with the fridge, so it was limiting someone else potentially also getting some meals out of it there. I never considered that might be an issue. We might have to set up another. We might have to dish some of these meals out into other refrigerators. What in the sh... Hello? Why have they all come in here? What the fuck was that about? Are they all trained in hauling? What was that about? What are they doing? Animals have restricted to the freezer. I don't understand what the fuck they're doing right now. That's horrifying. That's genuinely extremely unnerving. Just a bunch of spiders marching over to the freezer for reasons. 919 uranium. That's really good, but again, not what we needed at all. Oh god, we're still stuck in the steel problem. It's just never gonna fucking end, is it? What are those spiders doing? They're genuinely just walking into the freezers. They're not eating anything. They're just walking in, saying hello to Muffin, and then fucking off again. That's so weird. Yeah, I don't know what the hell we're going to do about the steel then. We've got them drilling. They've uncovered emerald under a mountain. We've got our settlements tithing, at which point we've given gold and uranium. We've had no trade ships that are selling steel. Oh, God. And we've got ground runners running underground who have uncovered a total of absolutely fuck all. I'm trying everything. I'm genuinely trying every avenue here, but we're so screwed in regards to steel. I think against my better judgment, I might just start strip mining again. Oh, God, they're doing it again. Hello. Where are they? Oh, this time they're going into the prison, are they? Oh, starting to go into the prison. Now they're going back. That's so weird. Ever since I moved Muffin into the freezer, I wonder if the baby blizzarisks have something in their behavior that makes them stick close to the area where the clutch mother is. A sort of a defensive thing. And they're trying to get over there, but of course they're restricted to a particular area, so they're going over there and then they're being overwritten immediately. I have no idea what would cause that. Anyway, I think we will have to start strip mining again, because right now we've done all this crazy shit. You know, we've researched all sorts of different turrets for our colony. We've researched robots. We've researched tools. We've researched armor, pulse weapons, the whole lot. And we can't do any of it because we've still got no steel. Like, sure, we've got 517, and when we take apart the mechanoids, we'll maybe go up to 1,000. But that's 1,000. And that's 1,000 that we've had for the past, like, 5 fucking episodes. I can't win. Yeah, I have no idea. I've never been at this much of a loss for steel. Of course, the last series in Royalty, we didn't have that issue, because every 5 minutes, the game was sending mechanoid clusters at us. Oh, I see what the issue is. They're seeking safe temperature. Because the power's been cut off from this. Oh, well, that takes the fun out of things. I was kind of enjoying the spider marches, but no, it's the fact that obviously they're dying of heat over there. Right, okay, so we need to get these cables done sooner rather than later. Building power conduit building. Yeah, Pork, if you don't mind, if you could get on with that rather than doing whatever the fuck it is you're doing right now. Recreation, to be fair. A stellar miner. Oh my fucking god, and I haven't got any silver left because we just spent it, as you can see in the top left-hand corner. Oh, I say we just spent it, but 5 days ago, obviously, it upgraded every single one of our settlements. Oh shit, okay. This is what we've been waiting for. This will at least give us a little bit of steel, maybe long enough to help keep things through. Maybe we'll spend this steel on robots, and then we'll send the robots underground to go and dig up just all the steel in the world, please. They haven't got any. They haven't got any. What do you mean they haven't got any? Stellar miner. Granite blocks, limestone blocks, marble blocks, sandstone blocks, slate blocks, amethyst, lapis, emerald, diamond. They don't sell steel. Fuck, I just can't. Please send help. Please. Please just let me. I just want one just to steal. Have they got anything else we want here? Oh, God. A purely diamond bathroom is the next goal, I think. No, nothing. There's nothing here. Nothing here. Get rid of that. Nothing here. This is breaking my spirit. Please. I just need a steal. In conclusion, goodbye, steel mine shaft. I'm just going to have them strip mine. It would have been worth it if there was a higher chance of finding resources down there or something like that. But realistically, we've left them underground now for basically the best part of 3 episodes. And they found a tiny little bit of... The tiniest little bit of plasteel. And that was it. And I can't, in good conscience, basically keep micromanaging. Oh, for fuck's sake. This fucking mod. I can't have the game running at this extremely slow speed and have nothing to show for it. Because it's making me take 10 times longer to obviously record all the episodes. You can't even get rid of it. I was going to say I'll remove this mod. Can't get rid of it. Can't get rid of it. Are you fucking kidding me? What if we shoot it? Pork. Pork, get your rifle. Blast this mine. I love that works. Oh, for fuck's sake. Long story short, that did not work. Shooting it with guns did not work. It just sat at 0 health. I reloaded it. It was still on 0 health. So I've gone ahead and removed the mod entirely. And that seems to have cleared things up. It's also had a little bit more speed back to the game as well. You can see that speed 3 isn't just basically... I mean, it's still fairly slow, but it's not as bad as it was there. That mod is unofficially updated, so I won't judge it too hard. It is a community attempt to keep that updated. for us, it's a bit of a waste of time, seeing as we're just going to be strip mining anyway. We might as well cut out the middleman and the sending of the resources down and managing ground runners on different levels. We might as well just keep it all on this, but instead set up the mine in a way that will, if we do get an infestation, not affect us. So if we mine through, say, here, for example, go down through this door, mine through here, and let the hauling bots haul everything back, that way we can avoid having a direct route straight to our base. This is a different trade ship. I think it actually is, because look, this is after we've pulled all the ground runners out. I think they've given us a second chance at the Stellar Miner. Oh, no, wait, there's no way. Maybe I just didn't turn the notification off. Oh, don't get my hopes up like this again. Oh, you fucker. It was the same one. Oh, there's a Galatross. Wow. What? Do you think we could tame it? 30% chance. Oh, God. Maybe just don't even bother trying then. I just want something to show for today. To be fair, we've built the new hydroponics bay. They've already started working on getting the things planted there. It wasn't quite a perfect lineup, I will admit. There's like a couple of spots where not everything was able to overlap. But besides that, it's obviously given us plenty of room for way more crops there. So I'm growing chili peppers, we've got pineapples, we've got soybeans. Over here we have wheat, we have tomato, we have cucumber and corn as well. So hopefully that will add a bit of meal variation. Now they're not just going to eat 40,000 corn like we were at yesterday. So we've got that show for us. We've got our biofuels. I put some more composters down there just to be able to keep up with the amount of demand we've got for our farm there. To be honest, I will admit progress has been very, very slow. I'm going to have to find a better... There's got to be a mod that lets us get steel more effectively than this, but still in a balanced way. There's no middle ground. But tomorrow, we start strip mining. And then I guess the episode after that, I'll probably complain about all the insects absolutely everywhere. Like I said, I'll keep things a little bit safer and we'll start the actual strip mining operation with no direct route straight to the base, because that's the trap I always fall into. Strip mining itself is not inherently bad. It's the fact that we give the insects a free front door entrance to our nuclear reactor, which is not always the ideal thing. Thank you to Leo, Harik, Necrophil, and Grimwolf, Surik 313, Alchemia, Pelvis Presley, Fakuna Vasquez, Harry McGowan, Blue the Lazy Archer, Rodin, Huey Longdong, Zetlock, Shay, Darth Hawk, and everyone else, the Insane Tier Lovers on Patreon, for keeping the channel going during these few months of YouTube monetization strangeness. Big shout out to these guys. And a thank you as well to Outer Mosterly, Fat Joe Isito, Ton Oster, Betamus Max, Asaro, Kiko, Kevin Saunders, Ryan Hooper, Spirit 085, Zulu, Brittany Lee, Callum McLeod, Tentacle Beast, Loves Trees, Ben Taylor, Jessica Smith, and everyone else at Patreon as well for their support and keeping the channel going. Thank you, guys. Much appreciated. See you all tomorrow for steel. Please, just for one steel.